So in the period of time today, I firmly believe there is no other way of definition of it. And I can tell you as a scholar, if someone shows me other group of documentation which really proves something different, I would say that, okay, it's no problem with it. I'm not stick in that sense on the term. I know its political importance, I know its legal importance, but for me, as an historian, most important thing is to understand the atrocity crimes as such, which is why, what happened and why it happened. And the set of documents that we have, I don't think that all, the other important issues, you cannot find one document that proves something. The genocide decision is a result of a set of documents. This is like a puzzle. We really put all these different parts together, and this is the conclusion that we derive from this set of documents. So,
curious about together with the definition of the genocide, like systematic killing of a people with a deliberate intent of ethnic cleansing. I was just curious why there are so many Armenians that are still living in Istanbul and in other areas in Turkey today, why they haven't been killed. Maybe not. I don't know the exact numbers, but there are still Armenians living in Turkey, and they are happy to live in Turkey. So I'm just wondering how you would explain that.
It's a wonderful question. Thank you for the question. In genocide definition, it is not important to exterminate the entire population. It says partly killing of the group, and it is in the definition. Another important information for you, if you look at the genocide or mass killing in the world, you will never find 100% of extermination of these human group. For example, the worst case scenario for us, the Holocaust. Because Hitler, no doubt, want to exterminate Jews as such, as a human being, in the entire world, not only in his sphere of influences. How many Jews were exterminated under the control of territory by Hitler? You know that? It's around 55-60%. In Rwanda, it is true, 55-60%. Never mind. This is Yehuda Bowers,
yeah, okay,
one of the Holocaust scholars. Most cases, the highest number that we have is the Rwanda, 80%. In Armenian cases, it is 55% of the population. So it has nothing to do with the number of the survivors. From Istanbul, there were also deportations. Happened 3-4 different waves, and the number of deported Armenians from Istanbul, according to a German source, is 30,000, must be exaggerated. But I found in Istanbul archives that according to 4 criteria, the Armenians were deported from Istanbul: unmarried youth, Armenians without any work, and Armenians who workplace outside of Istanbul, and Armenians who were suspected being in relation with any organization. According to these 4 criteria, regularly Armenians were deported, and in certain documents, German documents you can read, even though the Ottoman authorities promised us not to send any Armenians from Istanbul, they are continuing to deport the Armenians from Istanbul. This is, so there are deportation from Istanbul also. You think that the genocide is something, definition is something so bad, the 100,000 of peoples must die. Theoretically, it is actually not necessary. You know the Aboriginal people in Australia. The children were taken away from the families, given to the white people's homes, and they lost their culture, they lost their language and origins. And this is a genocide according to genocide definition, because it was done intentionally. And Ottoman archives, today in Istanbul, full with documents. I have an examples here. I can read all of them. central authority, Union and Progress Party Interior Minister, sends to the region forcibly removing Armenian children from the families, forcibly marrying Armenian girls to Muslims, and in the document it's also stated they should forget their language and culture. It's not necessarily the killing part. Only this set of documents, forcibly taking the family children from Armenian families, is a part of genocide definition, according if it's done intentionally, because these are the telegrams from central government organized intentionally. You can find the term of genocide there. So that's why I think the term of genocide is not actually so crucial in that problem. The basic problem is there are, because other, I can give you one more example. I found in Istanbul this summer a document, even though there were a purge action enough, it is sent to the eastern provinces by Talat Pasha, the interior minister. End of August, the telegram dated 21st August 1331, the old date. It's approximately 1 September 1915. Stop unnecessary killing in these provinces. Armenian question is generally solved, period. Interior ministry sends to the region to stop the killings. That's why, I mean, the material that we have in hand leaves us no doubt about that. That's why my argument is don't stuck on this term. Find another term that you use. Whatever term you want to use, use this term, but understand the human dimension of this. Understand the pain, understand the problems, the sorry. This is the most, the moral dimension is more important than which term are we going to stuck on that term.
Thank you.
1, 2, 3.
All right, thank you. This is Emre from Turkish Cultural Center. Turkish Cultural Center is Emre. I just would like to know, there's only one nation in Ottoman Empire, let's say Ottoman government. There's only one nation who named Millet-i Sadıka, that means loyal nation. The name came from Ottoman Empire itself. So why they named the Armenians Millet-i Sadıka, and then they start to kill them? Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, I was just wondering that in 1990 or around that, I think 2 million people government Armenia occupied some part of Azerbaijan, I think, and they still do that. And Azerbaijan kind of, I think, around 10 million. And I think in the constitution of Armenia, they're claiming that they own not only Ardahan, Kars, but also Van and Hatay as well. So what would you think about that, that we don't have any border problem in terms of their looking way?
Thank you.